the best horror games on Xbox Game Pass you can play right now. Discover the true meaning of fear in Alien Isolation, a survival horror set in an atmosphere of constant dread and mortal danger. 15 years after the events of Alien, Ellen Ripley's daughter Amanda enters a desperate battle for survival, on a mission to unravel the truth behind her mother's disappearance. As Amanda, you will navigate through an increasingly volatile world as you find yourself confronted on all sides by a panicked, desperate population and an unpredictable, ruthless alien. Underpowered and underprepared, you must scavenge resources, improvise solutions and use your wits not just to succeed in your mission, but simply to stay alive. What makes this game so scary is the persistent fear you are in from the truly dynamic and reactive alien that uses its senses to hunt you down and respond to your every move. Resident Evil 7 Biohazard set a new course for the Resident Evil series as it leverages its roots and opens the door to a truly terrifying horror experience. Set within a sinister plantation in Dulvey, Louisiana, and taking place after the dramatic events of Resident Evil 6, players experience the terror directly from the first person perspective, for the first time in the Resident Evil series, which I found really added to the fear factor. Embodying the iconic gameplay elements of exploration and tense atmosphere the series is known for, Resident Evil 7 Biohazard delivers a disturbingly realistic experience that will probably define your nightmares for the next few weeks. The evil within embodies the meaning of pure survival horror. Highly crafted environments, horrifying anxiety, and an intricate story are combined to create an immersive world that will bring you to the height of tension. With limited resources at your disposal, you'll fight for survival and experience profound fear in this perfect blend of horror and action. While investigating the scene of a gruesome mass murder, Detective Sebastian Castellanos and his partners encounter a mysterious and powerful force. After seeing the slaughter of fellow officers, Sebastian is ambushed and knocked unconscious. When he awakens, he finds himself in a deranged world where hideous creatures wander among the dead. Facing unimaginable terror and fighting for survival, Sebastian embarks on a frightening journey to unravel what's behind this evil force. Outlast 2 introduces you to Sullivan North and his followers, who left our wicked world behind to give birth to Temple Gate, a town deep in the wilderness and hidden from civilization. North and his flock are preparing for the tribulations of the end of times, and you're right in the thick of it. Oh, lucky you. You are Blake Langerman, a cameraman working with your wife Lynn. And just like Outlast 1, you unfortunately are just armed with a camera. And by that I mean you have no weapons. Stealth or running away is your only defense here. The two of you are investigative journalists willing to take risks and dig deep to uncover the stories no one else will dare touch. You're following a trail of clues that started with the seemingly impossible murder of a pregnant woman known only as Jane Doe. The investigation has led you miles into the Arizona desert to a darkness so deep and horrendous that it secures Outlast 2's place on our best horror games list. In Dead Space's future, Earth's appetite for resources has become a major motivator for deep space exploration. Immense privately owned and operated mining ships called PlanetCrackers, I love that name, orbit planets and use sophisticated equipment to carve out entire city-sized chunks of rock and reduce them to component elements and raw ore. Communications with one of these planet crackers, the USG Nishimura, has ceased while the ship is engaged in a deep space mining mission. The company's top engineer, Isaac Clark, is sent to discover the problem and fix it. Once on board the vessel, Clark discovers that a terrifying alien presence has taken over the ship and has horribly killed the crew. Weaponless and terrified, this lone engineer is burdened with much more than simple survival. He holds the fate of all mankind in his hands. The Medium is one of the first horror games I played on my Series S, and it is a super unique game as it is rendering two distinct worlds at the same time, which really shows off the power of the Xbox Velocity architecture. You become a medium living in two different worlds, the real one and the spirit one. Haunted by a vision of a child's murder, you travel to an abandoned hotel resort, which many years ago became the stage of an unthinkable tragedy. There you begin your search for different answers. As a medium with access to both worlds, you discover a dark mystery only you can solve. Use your unique psychic abilities to uncover its disturbing secrets, solve dual reality puzzles, survive encounters with sinister spirits, and explore these two realities at the same time. Now, Back 4 Blood isn't as terrifying as some of the other games on this list, but this is a thrilling co-op first person shooter from the creators of Left 4 Dead, where you are at the center of a war against the Ridden. These once human hosts of a deadly parasite have turned into terrifying zombies, hell-bent on devouring what remains of civilization. With humanity's extinction on the line, it's up to you and your friends to take the fight to the enemy, eradicate the Ridden, and reclaim the world. Fight your way through a dynamic, perilous world and a four-player co-op story campaign where you must work together to survive increasingly challenging missions, play with up to three of your friends online, or go solo and lead your team into battle. The Walking Dead is a classic Telltale game here, with their interactive story types they have become famous for, where your decisions will impact what happens next. Its key selling point is the story, and like all Telltale games, it will draw you in and make you feel way more invested in the characters than you were ever expecting. The main characters are Lee and Clem, and they are backed up by a whole host of characters, some you can trust and some you shouldn't trust at all. All this is going on in the midst of a zombie apocalypse, and many people you will grow to love will not make it out alive, and it is all up to your decisions. Visage is a first-person psychological horror game which seems to have got its inspiration from the infamous PT, which was going to be the next Silent Hill game which got cancelled unfortunately. I say unfortunately as it was genuinely scary. The good news is Visage is just as terrifying. This feels as if the developers at Sad Square have taken the concept of PT and fleshed it out into what a full game version of that would look like. Explore a mysterious, ever-changing house in a slow-paced, atmospheric world that combines both uncannily comforting and horrifyingly realistic environments, and enjoy a genuinely terrifying experience. In Visage, you are defenseless. Oh joy. No weapons can save you from the dreadful entities stalking you from every corner, the next door, or underneath your feet. You'll be able to pick up key elements, interact with the environment, and search for things that may help you escape this nightmare or pull you even deeper into it. The Dark Pictures Anthology is a series of standalone cinematic horror games, kind of like an interactive movie. Each game features a brand new story, setting, and characters with a fully branching narrative. In Man of Medan, five friends set sail on a holiday diving trip. As the day unfolds and a storm rolls in, their trip soon changes into something much more sinister. Who will live? Who will die? Well, it's all down to you, my friend. In A Plague Tale: Innocence, you follow the grim tale of young Amica and her little brother Hugo in a heartening journey through the darkest hours of history. Hunted by Inquisition soldiers and surrounded by unstoppable swarms of rats, Amica and Hugo will come to know and trust each other. As they struggle to survive against overwhelming odds, they will fight to find purpose in this brutal, unforgiving world. Set in 1349, the plague ravages the Kingdom of France. Amica and her younger brother Hugo are pursued by the Inquisition through villages devastated by the disease. On their way, they will have to join forces with other children and evade swarms of rats using fire and light. Aided only by the link that binds their fates together, they will face untold horrors in their struggle to survive. Now, if you're downloading all these horror games and you're running out of storage space on your Xbox, check out the card on screen now to see all the best storage options available for the Xbox consoles.